You know, the COVID-19 pandemic has proven to be one of the most trying times for scientists, doctors, and people alike. But as time goes on, we're discovering more and more. And one of the latest findings is showing up in an unexpected place.
You've seen the headlines about COVID hiding in the brain, but now researchers are finding the virus may also be living in your stool. A recent study identified COVID-19 genetic material along with 33 mutations in stool samples of COVID patients. They are finding that it can live in the gut even in asymptomatic patients for up to 45 days. This shocking finding not only changes what we thought we knew about transmission, but also supplies answers to COVID's perplexing behavior and why some people get hospitalized while others don't even get a fever. COVID is making your gut its home. What does this mean for you and the future of treatment and prevention?
Joining us is gastroenterologist and co-author of Let's Talk Dr. Sabine Hazen. Well, Dr. Hazen, you and your team were the ones that discovered COVID's entire genetic code in the stool. So why do you think the virus was found there in the first place?
COVID actually sits on the ACE2 receptor. Where is the biggest organ where the ACE2 receptor are found? The ACE2 receptors are found, the bowels. So it made sense to me to look there because that's where everything ends.
We heard in the tape that COVID can linger in your gut for up to 45 days. So the big question is, does that mean that it's transmissible for that long, doctor?
You know, we don't know. I think it's too early to know, but certainly that gives you an insight onto why does a worker go back to work and that person a month later, the colleagues or the workers are now positive, right? So right. They'll carry it in the gut, and therefore they clear their upper respiratory symptoms, but then it's still in the gut. And when he goes in the bathroom, it becomes airborne. So essentially, the bathroom is your biggest risk factor, the public bathroom. So you've got to be careful with that.
Why is this finding so important?
I think it's so important because at the end of the day, we need to understand what's going on in the gut. We need to understand who is going to die from COVID because of their microbiome versus who's not. For two, it makes a difference onto what therapy am I giving? I need a therapy that focuses on the gut. That's the most important thing.
So is there any way for people to determine if they have a strong or weak microbiome?
So we're not there yet. That's the whole basis of my research lab is really to write the dictionary of the microbiome and disease. We are seeing that if you have an imbalance in the gut, you are more predisposed to disease. We are seeing that diseases are all about imbalances. We're publishing all that. We started with autism, and we noticed that autism is actually potentially a gut dysbiosis. In other words, something in the microbiome is altered and we just need to replace it.